Hello, my name's Amanda Hill and I work for the Archives Association of Ontario. I coordinate a service they run called Archeion. This brief introduction to Archeion is aimed at archivists in Ontario who might be interested in using Archeion to share information about their archives online. Archeion is a way of connecting members of the public with information about the wide range of resources held in Ontario's archives. It has been going since 1999, and information in the service is contributed by archivists across the province. It's freely available for anyone to search or browse, and it's one of a network of provincial systems which feed into a national site called Archives Canada. This is the homepage for Archeion. And from here, people can search the site for information about archives related to their topic of research. They can also browse the archives by institution, by subject, place, or name, using the menu on the top left. If you work for an archive service and you want to contribute information to Archeion, you can do so in a variety of ways. This particular record shows a description of a voters list, which has been contributed by the City of Greater Sudbury Archives. You can see that a digitised image of the voters list is available from the description. On the left, you can see that the description of this item forms part of a larger group of records for the town of Sudbury, and that there is a hierarchy of fonds, series and files represented here. So this group of records has been described in some detail, but you don't have to go down to that level of information. If you want to just contribute an overall description of a group of records, that's fine too. Here is the same set of records on microfilm available at the Archives of Ontario. Here you can see that there's only a fond level or top level description, and it's much less detailed than the City of Greater Sudbury's version. What the Archives of Ontario do is provide a link in their descriptions to their own online finding aids, which are where you can find more information about their materials. So they use Archeion as a pointing device back into their own system, and that's obviously fine. If your archive service is an institutional member of the Archives Association of Ontario, contributing to Archeion doesn't cost you anything. One of the advantages of describing your archives in Archeion is that people will find your records without even knowing about the website, because the information in Archeion is available to search engines like Google. Sometimes this isn't the case with proprietary archival management systems. We find that 2/3 of all Archeion visitors come straight to the site from search engines. On the screenshot here, you can see an example of that. If you search Google for Iona Station Women's Institute, the first result you get back is the description of that organization's records on Archeion. Also, by putting your information into Archeion, you are presenting your archival materials alongside those of lots of other institutions from across Ontario. It helps users make connections between holdings without having to visit a dozen different websites. So, what information goes into Archeion? There are three main types of records in the service. There is information about your archival institution, information about the records you hold, the archival descriptions, and also authority records, which hold information about the people who created the records, individuals, organisations, or families. These are all combined into the online display. On this screenshot, you can see an example of an institutional record. This is the page for the Wilfrid Laurier University Archives. Here you'll find the contact details for the institution, a little bit of history about the institution, and its opening hours. And in the box on the left, under the heading Holdings, this information is coming from the archival descriptions from that institution, where the titles of the different descriptions are extracted and presented. This screenshot is an example of an authority record for the Toronto Dance Theatre. You can see the name of the organisation and some information about its history. On the left, you can see a list of the fonds which this organisation created and one which it is the subject of. It looks like we have repetition here, but actually these are two different fonts with the same name, one held at the Archives of Ontario and the other at York University Archives. This is a good example of the way Archeion pulls together information from different archives, making it obvious to researchers that one particular organisation's records might be held by more than one archival institution. This screenshot is an example of an archival description held at Whitby Archives, which is situated in Whitby Public Library. Most of this page is information about the records themselves, but in this box, you can see that there is information about the individual who created the records. Those details are being pulled in from the authority record, and the logo on the left is being pulled in from the institutional record. All of these different types of record are based on national or international standards, and these are the ones we're using in Archeion. And all of these records are editable by you if you're an Archeion contributor. So for example, if your opening hours or your email address should change, you can just log into Archeion and edit your archival institution's details to reflect that change. On this slide is a lovely image of a quilting bee from Elgin County Archives. I think it summarises the Archeion ethos very well. We're all working away on our own part of the service, but in the process we're creating something bigger that's really useful for archivists and the general public alike. If you're interested in contributing information about your archives to Archeion, or if you have any questions about the service, please email me at the address on this slide. This is one of a series of videos funded by the Government of Ontario to provide online training opportunities for archivists and archives users in Ontario. Thanks for listening.